Welcome to a video on the division of integers. This video provides the basic rules for dividing integers and provides several examples. I do have another video that goes over the explanations of the rules in much more detail. The rules for dividing integers are the same as the rules for multiplying integers. If the signs are the same, the quotient is positive. So a positive divided by a positive is positive, and a negative divided by a negative is also positive. And if the signs are different, the quotient is negative. So a positive divided by a negative is negative, and a negative divided by a positive is also negative. Let's try some. Now this first one we should already know. Positive 36 divided by positive 4 is equal to positive 9. And it does fit the rule of a positive divided by a positive is always positive. The second example, we have a negative 35 divided by negative 7. Well, a negative divided by a negative is positive, so this will be positive 5. Now remember, we can always check a division problem by multiplying. Going back to this first example, this means that 9 times 4 should equal positive 36. For the second example, this means 5 times negative 7 should equal negative 35. And it does. Now we have negative 56 divided by positive 7. Well, a negative divided by a positive will be negative. So here we'll have negative 8. And then here we have positive 27 divided by negative 3. Well, a positive divided by a negative will be negative. So this will be negative 9. And we can always check these with multiplication. For this example here, negative 8 times 7 should equal negative 56, and it does. And for this example, we'd have negative 9 times negative 3 should equal positive 27, and it does. Okay, there's one last thing to mention about division of integers. 12 divided by 0 is actually undefined. We can't take a certain number of items and divide it into groups of 0. That's not possible. So division by 0 is undefined. However, 0 divided by 5 would be equal to 0. We can take 0 items and divide it into 5 groups. It's just that each group would have 0 items. So 0 divided by a constant will always be 0. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found this review helpful.